You are being watched. Right now, at this moment, people you will never meet are compiling information on you, your family, your beliefs, your shopping habits, and what you might be doing a year from now. Think carefully about everything that implies, because the scenario described above is not a paranoid fantasy. This is the world we live in. I want to thank you and congratulate you for listening to this book, Tor and the Dark Net, Remain Anonymous and Evade NSA Spying. Hopefully, this will be your first step to protecting your privacy, your civil rights, and even your finances against the many digital threats we all face, and so few people are truly aware of. Online privacy exists only in as much as you claim it by your own actions. In this day and age, if you are using a computer or device that is connected to the Internet, you do not have automatic privacy. That is the simple truth. You need only to look at the user agreements for popular online services, such as Facebook or Dropbox, to realize this. The U.S. Supreme Court has even formally ruled that no confidentiality applies to webmail because it is transmitted and stored outside of the physical control of a sender and a recipient, much like paper mail is. Furthermore, unscrupulous individuals, criminal gangs, and, not least, governments, are all interested in what you are doing and what you have to lose. The NSA, the FBI, and sophisticated hacker groups, often allied with traditional organized crime, have the ability to track anything and everything you are doing. For some, this may not matter at all, as they don't care who has access to their files, data, browsing habits, or whereabouts. This only proves that many people fall into the ostrich trap, assuming that because a threat is mildly complicated, it can't possibly hurt them. They find the nearest convenient hole in the ground, stick their head in it, and hope for the best, right up to the moment when what they never saw coming hits them. So what if an identity thief obtains a loan in your name? It's the bank's problem, right? Well, no. Typically, the fraudster will get away clean, the bank's lawyers will wash their hands, and the victim will be responsible for clearing up the mess, if he doesn't have to pay back the loan he knew nothing about, too. So what if people know where you live? Your house isn't a secret bunker, after all. But consider a recent case of a medical doctor associated with a research institute that performs vivisection, experiments on animals, often cruel. An activist group took offense and published his home address, his and his wife's workplaces and telephone numbers, where their children went to school, all information voluntarily posted to social media, gift-wrapped and ready for an instant harassment campaign. So what if the government knows all about you? They already do, anyway, from your tax returns alone. Yet they spend more than $50 billion annually collecting a record of every phone call and every web interaction you make. The avowed purpose of this massive surveillance program is to keep us safe. Do you feel safer now? The good news is there are tricks and tactics you can use to insulate yourself from this. Inside this book, you will find step-by-step instructions and techniques that will make you completely anonymous on the Internet. If used correctly, not even the NSA will be able to sniff you out. Everyone's situation and the appropriate level of security is different, so this book breaks down the available options. Based on this information and the step-by-step guides in using them and precise definitions of what secure features each guide offers, you will be able to choose what works for you. It is my hope that this book is able to inform you of all your options to remain anonymous.